Okay, hello to the viewers, you're welcome on this special edition of the program Step Out. It's no other person but my humble self, Hansel Ngu. Today we are at Tam Tam and at Entree Savannah. We are heading to Marco Fufu's place. That's where we'll be hosting one of our guests today. And that's why we call on you guys to stay with us. Don't hesitate, subscribe on our YouTube channel, Step Out TV Show. And don't hesitate as well to always share our content. We'll be leaving you guys with a musical break of this young talented artist signed under the label at Jim C Records. He's no other person called General Pele Pele. Enjoy this new tune of his and we'll catch you after with our guest. Love you.
Master Roboster on the beat.
Step Out, which is no other person burn. My humble self, Hansel Ngu, and we are on David Camp Television and broadcasted, produced by Channel Music. You know what it is? We are Marco Fufu space, and we decided to start at this, you know, comfortable space where we can play, how do they call this? Okay, this is an amazing game, and I believe we're going to be having fun right now. So, and with no other person, Bird, the 237 young, talented comedian, producer, and actor. So, he's going to be telling us more about himself while we are having fun. So, first thing we're going to say is, bro, since you claim you know how to play Dami, let's do the test first before I start the conclusions.
Okay, let's go.
Oh God, I'm also a good player. So bro, tell us, present yourself to our televiewers. Who is Team Clarence? You know, so many people know you, but you know, it would be better you present yourself again.
Okay, I'm called Team Clarence, and Team Clarence that you see here is a filmmaker. Team Clarence is an actor. He's a documentarist. He is a comedian. In fact, I'm everything as far as entertainment is concerned, except dancing and singing.
Okay.
Because I don't actually love dancing and singing.
So. That's interesting. That's very interesting. So, bro, while we keep playing, I would ask you another question. You know, how did you come about your passion for comedy?
Okay, for my passion for comedy, I think it all started when because I grew up being inspired by all these Nollywood actors and actresses. So I got up one day, I said that, okay, why not give a try on this domain? That should be when I was in form 5.
Yeah, you can play alongside me.
So I said that, okay, let me try and see how this can be like seeing the Team Clarence that you don't know on screen. So I started with him. I think yes, my film, and I think the first film that I acted, the host was there. You played the role of a pastor. That should be End of Lucifer.
Yeah.
So I was actually on set that day, but although I acted as a standby character. So. And I've been
from there.
And I've also been to sets, and I saw that I was just given minor roles. I said that okay, why not also start up what I know I can do best, or what I can. So I decided to say that okay, from today I'm going to be into comedy.
Okay.
I went into comedy skits, and from there I decided to say okay, if I can do comedy skit perfect, why not try filmmaking? So I went into I did script writing, and I wrote my first film, which was titled Mistaken.
Mistaken.
Yeah. So that was where I kicked off. From there I realized that as a producer I was not like financially fit to keep up with the game. So I just said okay, if Cameroon films are like, for you to see a Cameroon film, maybe it should be on CRO TV. And I've so far I've just seen few Cameroon films on TV. So I decided to say why not do comedies that a lot of people can actually put on their status as short as they are. So I immersed myself into comedy. So that was how it came.
It started.
Yes.
Okay, that's very great. So, bro, we noticed that you not only being a comedian, you treat a whole lot of, how would I say, established artists to work with you. They came over, I can call readings, Madasco, there are other people I don't know. So, how did you captivate them? Because these people are only attached to excellence.
Yeah.
And if they came over to do videos with you, we are going to be seeing some of those videos with our musical breaks. So, how did you get to get them on your stuff, and what was your first surprise as a young comedian?
Okay, to that I would say that it was determination and desperation, because I came to an extent, I saw that if all these artists have that popularity, okay, I saw that if I attach them into my comedy skit, I can also gain like some of their fans too as well. So I said that okay, why not give a try? Although to me it was so much very hard, because I would never had somebody like a manager that could go and talk for me, and I just go and I go directly. So I at times I used to text them on Instagram, Facebook, and no one replies. So I said that okay, why not give a try? Sometimes I text, they say it's a manager, and I was like scared of, because of financial stuff. So I said that okay, why not give a try? So unfortunately one day I was sitting in the house, a friend of mine texted that Mangon was here. So I said that okay, why not give a try? I took Mangon's number, I text him. For unfortunately he accepted the collaboration, and that was my first skit that I did with an artist, Mangon. So the second was We Show You. So I also text with him, and he said that I should come over to Douala. And there were a lot of difficulties, because I for once I don't have somebody that I live with there in Douala. And housing and transportation too as well was a problem. I decided that day was amazing, because I had only 7,000 on me, and I was like how am I going to do, how will I cope with all these things. I said that okay, where there is life there is hope. I kicked
off. Your way, and it was a success. Great. Now what can you say about the state of comedy in Cameroon? Because you know there's a difference between comedy kid comedians and stand-up comedians. Do you think you guys have a collaboration, like comedians who stand up in public and do comedy, you know, and talk and make people laugh or the like, and for those like you who do kids, do you think you guys work together? Because we've noticed in some of your videos these people don't feature you. So what's going on?
Okay, so that is actually my plan B. My plan A was to first of all do collaboration with all these artists. So I have to do with Bless B, Clogri, a lot of them. So I've spoken with them and everything is set. So stand-up comedians like Yuri Stakam, I've been with them. Someone like Senior Pastor, I've also spoken with Senior Pastor, and he asked me to come over to Limbe. So that was it. Even Oga, the one Francophone, yes, he does comedy. So I've also have a chat with some of them, and they have actually asked me to come over.
Okay, that's very great. So ladies and gentlemen, we would like you guys to have a taste of one of his comedy kids, and we want to tell you guys that it wouldn't cause you any problem if you really do like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and as well follow Tim Clarence on Instagram. He's doing amazing in the world. It's on Step Out TV show. We leave you with this short comedy kid, and we catch you just after back with Ah, yes, I love you.
mais je m'en fous, je m'en fous de cette femme.
Yeah, for a celebrity like you, I can do anything.
Oh my god.
So. I'm not going to do it right.
Yeah! This man!
This guy.
He's shock up!
I'm a boss in motor this though.
He's shock! And I am who I do. I'm a boss in motor
this.
Not be juju be that.
Now wait till you say, I beg go.
I just want you to change.
I cannot change.
C'est la magie. Tant que n'est pas le caillou, laisse ça, laisse ça. Quand Sabina comme Mando, soya na. I don't fit, can't tell which I love. Mais si tu es jabonica, soya na. Tolé, serré, fadi ça.
It's a love. Steven's music.
Pas faux tout de nassé. La vie c'est du mais on l'est jamais tombé. Put power, one day.
Gentlemen, you're welcome back on the program Step Out, and you know we are with the young, talented comedian, same as actor and producer, Tim Clarence. So, guys, we are at Marco Fufu, and it's no other place but in Yaoundé and the beach at Tam Tam and Trace Savannah. So, don't worry about the noise behind. It's all about, it's all about us. It's all about people coming to have their meal, and that's what's necessary. So, the first, we get back with our guest and ask him for a few questions. So, Tim, I would like you to tell us, you know, you said you're up with a movie project. How does it go? How does it work with you? How's it going?
Okay. The project is going on well because I'm going to be releasing the episode that's on the 10th.
Yeah.
So, what I can vividly remember is there are the difficulties that I encounter in doing all this.
Yeah.
As you can see, I don't have any producer, I don't have any director, so I do everything by myself. I do the script writing, I do the acting, I do the directing as well. So, in fact, I would just like everybody to just see, watch what I'm up to.
Yeah.
Because this movie is titled Not My Inheritance, and it's actually something which has a lot of sense in it.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and it's also among with the characters that I use are mostly comedians.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yes, mostly comedians,
yeah.
Upcoming comedians that are in the entertainment world.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided to take in this phase, although in the other episode I'll bring in also established actors to also come and feature.
Give you their test. So I noticed that you took a lot of upcoming comedians, and I don't know, is it because you never had the support of the established actors or the young, the talented, already established comedians? I don't know. Why did you start with them?
Okay.
Is it that you're giving them an open light to showcase their talent first? Or is it because maybe you never had that assistance from those already there? So try to tell us.
No, that's not actually the case, because my first film that I did was Mistaken. And there, I think, my established actor was from Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
So, I have the support, but I just wanted to make it in such a way that I just wanted to make it so that everybody should know that even the upcoming to also have a place, because
yeah.
I too, for once, when I entered the entertainment, I don't know whether it was because I was too small for the people that was casting me or what. So I just wanted to make it in such a way that they should know that becoming, whether you are young or old, you have a role to play.
You have a role to play.
Yes. So that is why in this first phase I've needed all these young young upcoming comedians to give them a play. And in the second episode, I'll make sure that also the established actors too, as well as you also have a place.
A place. Okay, that's great. And we noticed that I had the opportunity to see, watch a little slice of that movie of yours, which you're still working on.
Yeah.
You know, now the issue is, I noticed that the costume, it was all epic. You know, why did you choose this genre of film production? You know, it's very costful. You know, people run away from it because it's too expensive to produce. But you took this up single-handedly with the support of no one to make it real. So how come?
Okay, so this epic, the reason why I decided to do epic way was because I had the mindset of, like, I asked myself this question: if I want to do glamour, Nigerian has done everything, Ghanaians have done everything. So I decided to say that, okay, let me try it this epic way, because Cameroon as a whole have a lot of cultures. So I decided to say that, okay, why not, in Cameroon we have over 200 tribes, so I decided to say, why not just pick up one tribe and try to demonstrate, to show something that others have not done. So I decided to take the epic way. And concerning the costumes, I actually did the costume by myself.
Yourself?
Yes, because I was so opportune to meet someone who was working on this costume or this film over my dead body. So from over my dead body.
So you made a costume?
Yes. Yeah, I made the costume, and I also met Evitron. Yes, Evitron, this movie that is on Afrik Media Prime. So I also did part of the costume. From there, I gathered the experience in doing the costume. So this time around, I said that, okay, let me do my own costume by myself and see what I can
do. What it looks like.
Yes.
And it was amazing.
And it was amazing.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, what we do is we're soon getting solved by the boss himself of the space, Marco Fufu. And we invite everybody to come over here and have a taste of it. You know what it is. So, in as much as the place you played is so delicious, we'd like to know more about you. You've met a whole lot of established leaders in our nation, like ministers who awarded you, who supported you and gave you certificates. How did they get to know about your skills, you know?
Okay, this was due to one day I was still in the house and a friend of mine sent me a competition on film scriptwriting, and I was very new as far as documentary was concerned, so they asked us to write a film documentary. So I just took the thing, since I was really in that, I said, okay, why am I doing this thing? I decided I abandoned it. So one day again, when I was sitting in the house, I saw the information passing on CRTV. So as it was on CRTV, I said, is this not what a friend of mine said? I said, let me give it a try. So I gave it a try and I wrote a film documentary. What I wrote actually was a feature film, and what was expected of course was a documentary. So they called us to a class at Cité Bella at Hotel de Ville. They briefed us on what was needed. So I actually wrote the film documentary on gender equality. That was when I had the access to meet the Minister of Women Empowerment. So from there I had to ask her a little bit questions on how the documentary is going to look like. Because the documentary was under gender equality, but on a woman on agro-jima. The reason why we put it a woman on agro-jima is a passionate woman actually who decided to carry on agriculture but in the industry sector. So we asked ourselves that this is a domain that normally we're supposed to control by men. Why this woman?
A woman chooses.
So I decided to say, okay, let us fight something on this.
And you were awarded a certificate for that?
Yes, and I was awarded a certificate for that.
So that's great.
It was so unfortunate that a lot of people were there, Minister of Act was there, and even the French baller champion that I feel, Lilian Thuram, left all the way from France and he was there too.
That's great. I like that. Okay, I think we are at the end of our interview and we really want to thank you so much for making yourself available.
Thank you, sir.
You know, and we are very happy because we are received warmly here at Marco Fufu. And the place is very beautiful. So we call on everybody in the city of Yaoundé to come over if you like to have good food, traditional meal of our own, you know, origin. And the space is beautiful as well, so you have no worry about that. Now, what we can say is, if you have a word for all those who love you and those future supporters of yours, maybe you could say it right now.
Yes, the only thing I can say is that if you have been dreaming, keep dreaming. Don't stop dreaming. as they used to say in pidgin, if you abandon whatever thing you're doing, if you give up, now you fuck up. So I'm sorry, I don't know anything.
Okay.
Yes. Because that's I came across some certain people who used to write me and say, Clarence, can I be partaker of in your movie or your comedy? And I realized that not everybody has a dream. Some people come to artists, like I met an artist and he told me that some people come and say, I'm an upcoming artist. But when they say, what have you done to show that you're an upcoming artist? There's actually nothing. That
nothing. No effort.
No effort. No songwriting. Yeah. Nothing. Nothing. So if you dream that you can do something, even if you don't have the camera, if you have a phone that you can use, start with your phone. You don't know where you can learn it tomorrow. And I also plead on everyone to follow me on Instagram, Mumuboy, follow me on Facebook, Tim Clarence. I'm going to be having some of my comedies and also with actors, musicians. Magasco is going to be with me, Clover is going to be with me, everybody. So
it's great.
It's going to be.
Okay, thank you so much. We are at the end. It's a Step Out TV show produced by Channel Music. And we love you guys so much. We are Marco Fufu. Monsieur Kenyé, je pense qu'il est temps que ceux qui nous regardent tout à l'heure voient un peu de ce que notre plat est constitué. Et je pense que c'est intéressant parce qu'il faudra que les gens viennent ici et débusquer ces plats. Ils en ont besoin. Et voilà. Bro, I think this is your player.
Thank you.
These people have their own tap water. That's great. Let me drop my phone.
Yes, no, keep my phone. Made at Marco.
Okay, we love you guys. Next edition of Step Out TV show.
Why don't you leave it for your uncle?
I don't want to see Ebuka's leg in that land again.
Oh, oh, some sweet for wine. That
you want to kill me as you kill Ebuka's father?
You want to kill Ebuka?
Forget about that man. That man is a case now. Forget about him. And then you are the one.
It should be the last time.
Now you also die so that I can kill you.
What? Get inside!
Boy,
it's a love. Steven's music.
Pana pour today na say. La vie c'est du mais on l'est jamais tombé. Yeah.